Hey guys, this is Craig Migliaccio with AC ServiceTech, and today what we're going over is copper tube swaging. So we're enlarging a copper tube to accept another tube to get ready to either solder or braze a joint. So this is soft copper, and we're going to be making this opening in the copper tube using each of these tools. So these are hammer swages, this is a hydraulic swaging tool, a manual swaging tool, spin swages, a standard flare and swage block, and we're going to ream the tubing with a stick reamer, a unibits, and a round reamer. Also, make sure to check out our book, The Refrigerant Charging and Service Procedures for Air Conditioning. In this book, we'll go over the system preparation for refrigerant charging, and also troubleshooting. This book is available over at Amazon.com and also at our website at acservicetech.com. The direct links for the book are down in the description section below, as well as the tool links for each of the tools in this video. I first want to go over what happens after you cut a copper tube, and what's going to happen is it's going to be very sharp. So the copper tube is going to be sharp on the end, it's going to be indented inwards, and we need to go ahead and ream that. So I'm going to show you the different reaming tools that we're going to use, and I have you up for a close-up, but we usually spin this tool. So we go around once and we turn this wheel, maybe about a quarter turn, and then we go around again. And so every 1 to 2 turns, you're going to just keep edging this wheel in until this copper tube ends up falling off like that. So once we have this done, and you see that this very sharp on the end right there, I'm first going to use my stick reamer, and a stick reamer just cuts right along the inside, and this tool works very well. I use this very often prior to swaging. So right there, that's done. Here's another stick reamer, and this one just has a larger handle, so that's also nice. So once again, you just go right around in a circle, and then you're done. And here's our unibit. So if we were going to ream copper tubing that's very small, we want to keep our fingers away from this edge because the copper tube could spin while we're reaming it. And then you want to keep it away from this side because that's where our unibit is going to be coming in at, and you don't want to have your fingers near there. So this is very simple to use. And that's it. So you don't need to spend a whole lot of time. So if you are reaming a lot of copper tubes, a unibit is a good solution. Here's our reaming wheel. So you just stick this right in the inside and you just turn this. This is a very basic tool. I always have this in the truck as well. And so you just tap that when you're done. You want to make sure that any shards that you're reaming out of the inside of the copper tube do not fall down inside the tube. If you have a line set that you're working on, you always want to do it in a downwards position so it all falls out. This is a manual swaging tool, and here's your die. And what you do is you just set this right on and you screw it on. And as you put the copper tubing on and you push this together, you're going to have this open up, and that's what's going to expand your copper tubing. Also, you want to notice that you're going to have these little seams here, so I always turn the copper a little bit as I am swaging. So this is 5/8 copper tubing, so this is OD 5/8, and this is also referred to as ACR tubing. That's a soft copper that's dehydrated. So we're just going to go ahead and set that on here, and then we're going to do about halfway, and then I'm going to turn it. So that's halfway. And you don't want to force it at the end, because what will happen is you'll accidentally open this up too much, and then it won't accept the copper very well. So it'll be too big, and then you'll have to fill in the joint in here while brazing, or silver soldering. So you want a nice tight joint. You don't want it to be too wiggly or have too big of an opening in here. Here's our hydraulic swaging tool, and in this case you don't have to screw it on very much. You just turn it and it's on just like that, and you just take this copper tube and slip it right on. But you also have this little ridge on the end too if you need to open it up if the copper tube is not fitting right on there. So it's the same premise. You're just going to go ahead and squeeze, and it's going to ream the copper tubing, but I usually go ahead and halfway through, I turn the copper tubing a little bit. So it makes it very easy. I'm just going to hit this button right here and turn it. So then we're just going to go ahead and squeeze it again, and you don't want to force it at the end. Once it starts to get snug, then you know that you're done. So you just press this button again right here, and that's it. And you open up this, and there's your copper tubing. Here's an up-close view of the manual swage and the hydraulic swage. So it does make a round swage, but you do see it's marked up on the inside for where the die is pressing up against the copper tubing to expand it. Here's our standard flare and swage block, and we have a 5/8 swage right here mounted onto the head. So these are interchangeable, and we want to make sure that the copper tubing is out the correct distance. So basically, the amount that you're going to be wanting to swage it plus this small part right here, because this small part is going to be going into the copper tubing inside the block right here, and the rest is going to be swaged. So you tighten these wing nuts right here with this, the end of this, and you just go ahead and put it on just like that. So that's how it's on there, like this, and then you're just going to go ahead and turn it. So I might just reposition this camera a little bit, but for now I think it's good. You can see that this takes a little bit more effort than some other things, such as the manual swager, but it's not bad. You have this long rod, and you can just go ahead and turn this. I'm just trying not to lose the video right here with taking this out of the sight. Okay, so that's it right there, and then you just back it up. And then you can take it out. So that's our swage. So here you see that when we put a copper tube in there, it's snug. All right, so it's not too open, and that one will be ready to go. You want to make sure to not over tighten these either, or else you're going to be really squishing the copper tubing where the block is holding onto the tube at. So that's where the tube was being held at. You see that it's squished down a little bit, but it needs to be able to hold it so that as you're swaging the copper tube, it doesn't just push through. So you want to make sure that it's tight enough, but not over tight. So here we have our tube and our spin swage, and you want to hold the tube with gloves. And the reason is you don't want the copper tube to spin. And the other thing is you want to protect your hands because it's going to really, really heat up fast. So here we go. You really need a high power drill. This is not a high power drill, so now we're going to put it in low speed. And there we go. So the object is to spin it very quickly, have enough torque to get in there, and you're spinning it quickly in order to heat the copper tube up in order to expand it. So here's our copper tube, and you can see in the inside. One nice thing about this is it's prepared on the inside for breeze, so you see it's nice and clean on the inside, and you want to make sure to hold the drill as straight as possible, otherwise you're going to get slop, and basically the copper tube's going to be moving a little bit. You don't want to have that much room in between this copper tube and the swage, so you want that as small as possible. And the other thing is you don't want to continue drilling it for a long period of time, because what will happen is that bit will rub up against the copper and you could end up having some copper dust go down into the inside of the tube. You also want to have this tube downwards as you're doing this procedure. So you might see a little bit of little pieces of copper and stuff like that, but it just depends on how quickly you can do this. So you want to heat it up fast and use your drill and get it done quickly. Last but not least are the hammer swages. So I've been using these for as long as I've been in the trade. Now these are newer, but my older ones in the truck, I just end up grinding the ends down where they mushroom out from hitting them, but I'll show you how to use this. They are very reliable tools as well. So I have each of the different sizes in the truck. So as you are hitting this, what you want to do is you want to hold on to this with maybe three fingers and hold on to the swage with two. The thing is, as you are hitting, what's going to happen is if you don't hold on to the swage, it's going to bounce back out. So you want all the force from your hammer to actually go into the copper tube. Now you could also put a flare and swage block on this as well to help hold it, but that's what you need to do. So that's how you do it. So as I put this in here, you can see that there's not a lot of slop. So you want to hit your swage in straight as you're hitting it. So that's good right there. And I'll take you up for a close-up image of this swage as well. So here's a close-up of that swage. And you see that that fits in real well, and there's not much space around the tubing. So that would make a good swage in order to braise with. So remember that we have all these tools linked down in the description section below, and check out our book and also our ebook. These are available over at acsurfacetech.com, and we have a full outline and sample pages posted there. This book is also available over at amazon.com. Hope you enjoyed yourself, and we'll see you next time at AC Surface Tech Channel.